I got brown, I got black, what you want? Hop off the wood and I land on more wood. I invested in that wood, cause I ain't dumb. We don't just have wood, but we also got rum. They wanna buy some. This the AO able man, can I buy your wood? I answer if you ask, of course anybody could. But since you're already here, I think you should buy my really good wood. I got burnt, I got blue, what you want? I can make a boat for your boy to dance on. You can use it to go fishing, man, you can make a ton. There's so many things you could do, I could probably reach the sun.
Hello, I'm Abel Adiano, and I'm doing the New England colonies. The New England colonies were the furthermost colonies of the 13 colonies. There were 4 colonies in it: New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and Connecticut. Geography, well, they were really far north, of course, and they had really rocky soil, which made farming for them really, really hard. That's why they subsistence farmed, which was farming for mainly just their families. Outside of that, they had a very mountainous terrain. Economically, they did a lot of lumbering, as there were very dense forests in the area. They also did a lot of fishing, as there were natural harbors, really, a lot of natural harbors. They also made a lot of rum, as another really big export to them. They were really good craftsmen, and liked to make tons of things, including ships. All of the colonies were very nice to the natives, as they all escaped from religious prosecution. All of them formed colonies, because they were being religiously prosecuted in England, except for New Hampshire, which was being religiously prosecuted within the other colonies.
Massachusetts, one of the main colonies in it, which included the city of Boston, they had the Pilgrims, which got on really well with the natives, and of course later had the first Thanksgiving. But leading up to the Pilgrims even landing in America, they created the Mayflower Compact, which was a governmental paper, which helps to establish law and order in the land. The other political institution in the New England colonies were the Fundamental Orders of Connecticut in, of course,
Connecticut.
All of the people that stayed in the New England colonies were mainly Puritans, Pilgrims. The New England colonies' main city was, of course, Boston, which you have seen in my Minecraft part just a couple minutes ago.
Hello, my name is Miguel Portillo, and today we will be talking about the New England colonies. So, I hope you're ready to enjoy. Today we will be starting off, you know where, Pennsylvania. You know who established Pennsylvania? The Quaker Oats guy. You know Quaker Oats? You know that?
Yes, sir, I do know Quaker Oats. I like to eat it commonly in the morning.
Yeah, you know the guy on the bottle?
Yes, I like him. One time I had a sticker of him and I put him up on my locker, but the sticker wasn't very good and it fell off.
Okay, not too much information, but on the other hand, he founded Pennsylvania. He was a Quaker. Quakers are against violence, and my main man, he established that each person could vote for a representative of their choosing for their legislative body. He was a Quaker, as I mentioned before, and he established this great, great, great state of Pennsylvania.
What was his name, though?
William Penn.
Oh.
Yeah. Now, the geography of this land, as you can see here, had a very large forest. Don't mind that. That's a UFO. Now, these forests were great, 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 great for shipbuilding, which my friend over in the New England colonies, he'll be doing it. Abel Ariano.
Grassy ass, that is me.
He's got some great, great, great wood wraps.
Word. Sure.
You saw before, you should have. If you didn't like it, oh well. He didn't do that good, so I don't know.
It did in like 20 minutes.
Okay, whatever. Yeah, that's what they all say. Now, the colonies here, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and your main man, Delaware. Those guys right there make up the middle colonies in the middle region. Now, their main economic exports, you know what they were? You know what they were?
I have no idea.
Well, that doesn't count. It's called rye and wheat.
Rye and wheat? Haven't I seen those on the bigger oat boxes?
Maybe you have. Correlation? I think so. But alongside that, these great, big, beautiful farms, most people farmed and made money off their rye and their bread. You know what the middle colonies are also known as?
I have no idea. What are they known as, Miguel?
The breadbasket.
What? But they're not a basket, they're colonies.
Yeah, but they grew a heck a lot of bread. Mucho, mucho bread. Now, that bread, grape and soups, clam chowder too. Now, I'm going to give you one detail about New York. New York was not founded by the British. No. They were founded by my main brothers. From the Dutch Bros. The Dutch Bros.
Orange!
Woo-hoo.
For Dutch!
The Dutch here, Dutch, they did it because of the money. They did it for the money. Now, they had natural harbors here, so great for shipping. As you can see here, my beautiful, beautiful little shipping boat.
Quite a pretty little ship.
Thank you. And ship building, that's all they did. And they have pretty good soil for farming. What was it again, Abel?
Bread.
Nice.
Wheat.
Yes, sir.
Holy ship. That's a lot of stuff they can do.
Yeah, they can, Abel. Now, their religion, this place was great if you were any religion because they accepted you no matter what. The Quakers did not want war and they very much were against slavery. No slaves, you wouldn't find any slaves here.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's insane.
Right? Now, I think that wraps everything up pretty well, but let's give you a quick tour of our town. It's a model town in the Middle Colonies. As you step in, you see the blacksmith, where you can repair your tools. He's got his little bed and everything. Then you got your, then you got your beautiful little library with beds. Then, you got a little house where subsistence farming, vocabulary words, high vocabulary. He grows his own food. Then right here, you got the library, another one, because we love to read.
All right, guys.
Then right here, this is William Penn's
I'm
house.
I'm going to take on me now.
And his little ship.
All right.
Great big house for a very important man.
Quite a big boy house.
And we got a church. Don't you just look at that church. What a sexy church that is.
Look at
that. Again.
In this Minecraft.
Everybody do this.
So
church is in section.
Church is in section.
What's that I found?
Now, is that a good church? Good church. And we got another little. This is our shipbuilding house right here. Don't ignore that. Kick it. No. That's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this voluptuous video. And goodbye, Gamer Nation.
Yo,
finally!
With my Minecraft pickaxe and shovels.
What are we gonna do tomorrow?
So, this is how it went. The king got an urgent message from the Virginia Company offering gold. So we offer you gold, okay? But we need a charter. King, perhaps. We depart from England in 1607 with roughly 105 passengers on board on the mission to find gold. tight. I'm out. So off they go. A trip of 4.5 minutes. Doesn't start throughout the journey and even within the colony when they live there for a couple of months. I finally checked for them. Colonists didn't find gold. And colonists were constantly attacked by natives. So they pleaded that they had no gold. But John Smith brought tobacco and grew filthy rich, but they had to push it to mercantilism. All colonies were forced to do this. It wasn't a win-win situation, but they agreed to do it anyway. Offered the king raw goods and tobacco.
Yeah, it is.
Other colonies like Georgia owed money to England, so he got named. And below the England of Florida men were coming. Also, the slave trade was involved because of the demand of labor, and the slave owners decided the slave's fate. The land was relatively flat and had fertile soil. Also, the Virginia House of Burgesses. They were the first to have representative government in the colonial era.
That's all, folks.